make our sausage gravy. So I'm going to take some raw sausage. It's actually four patties and a little bit of butter in a pan, and I'm going to brown off this sausage really good. Everyone's probably made sausage gravy at home, right?
Yes, sir.
This is easy money. It's the same thing as a pan gravy like we did with the beef. It's the same process, except I'm going to yield grease from the sausage also, so I don't need as much butter to make a roux. And then with my sausage gravy, I always use heavy whipping cream instead of milk, because heavy whipping cream is much richer. It makes much, much better gravy.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. A little higher in calories. Nobody wants to trust the skinny chefs. Alright, as that's browning off, I'm going to add a little bit of black pepper. I like a good spicy sausage gravy. And again, these burners don't cook nearly as well as the stove. So today, if we get a little low on butane, because it looks like someone's been using our butane also, we'll just walk over to this kitchen over here and use the burners in that kitchen. Also this morning, you're going to make French toast and pancakes. I'm not going to demo French toast and pancakes. It's very simple. Pancakes, mix up the batter. You're going to turn on a flat top over there and just work your way up through the flat top. And you cook your pancakes until they have holes in them, and you flip them over. Then they brown off on one side and flip them over. French toast, the only key that you need to understand about French toast is you have to soak the bread until it absorbs the liquid. Because you want it to be a custard consistency. You don't want it to taste like egg-coated bread. Does that make sense?
Yes,
sir.
We got bread, sir.
Yeah, two omelets with
a... You want to get all of our ingredients as soon as this is over. In fact, we just volunteered to go with you.
Yes, thank you, sir.
Alright, so once I have my gravy or my sausage working here, I got a nice brown on it. Brown does not mean burn. Remember, you only have to cook pork at what temperature?
155.
It's brown, so it has to be 155. Brown 155. When it's brown and you see that grease boiling around it, it is just perfect. So now I'm going to cook a little bit. Gravy doesn't really matter what color it is, so I'm not so worried about using a stainless steel pan. Now, if I was making a sauce, I'd be really worried about it because I want it to be nice and clean in color. So the gravy is incorporated so quickly that it really doesn't change colors. Now, once you get the gravy done, you need to get it out of your pan and go back and wash your pan so you're not doing all day. Does that make sense?
Yes, sir.
Everybody hear me on that? Gravy's done. Go back and wash your pan. Yes, you have. Anytime you're making a sauce or a soup or anything that you thicken with, you have to bring it to a boil. There's some low-fat versions of this. You can use skim milk or low-fat milk. And you can use cornstarch slurry to thicken this up awesome. That's going to take a lot of the calories out of it. This sausage gravy is just a little thick. Just going to add a little more cream to it. Usually, and I think your recipe calls for a tiny cream. want the sausage gravy to be really thick. We want it to be really thick. See how thick that is?
Yes, sir.
And once it's thick, you add some seasoning. Grab a hold and stick to the ribs gravy.